Tower of Art. Beckert has already organized more than 8 national and international art projects successfully in the last 3 years. Okay, now I would like to mention some of our projects which are really based on a different kind of stuff, like city, like urban and rural areas, and some of them are about performance art. So urban hours. Yeah. It's one of our first initiative. I mean, it's actually the first initiative of Becker. So on the way of our daily life, we are used to maintain an urban living style. And the urbanization of Dhaka isn't proper actually, as we believe. The traffic system, lack of proper building code, backdated sewer system design, political instability, air pollution, lack of job, drinking water, load sharing, crimes. I mean, so many problems we're facing every day in Dhaka. But Dhaka has its own history with glory and honor. So this project goal is to focus on the relation between our daily lifestyle in the city and the glory entity of our cities. And in today's context, where we live is so far fast and seeking of modernity faced brutal complexity in our every hour of each urban life. Even the rural life or even the childhood, green grasses, clean skies, fresh air, playgrounds, ponds are no more today. Is this we are sagging for? Is this the modernity we are hoping for? So that was the basic questions, like the Beckert want to involve community people and the artists in the projects, that their works can ask such questions like that. Sometimes we feel, do we need a proper urban system? So the first season was in 2014. It was in Rose Garden. It's very, very near to Motichilli. It's such a crowded and official space. Like those people who do their job on this area, they even don't know that there is a beautiful building over there. On the one of the most significant building of that glorious time is Rose Garden, which was created by a Hindu zamindar Rikesh Das in the late 19th century. And it was brought by Khan Bahadur Abdul Rashid from Rikesh Das in 1936. So the history tells the aesthetical aspects of the palace. Okay, there were 16 individual artists and their artworks. Mostly we have done site-specific installations, performance arts and sound works. This is one of the work from Sanjit Mahmud Bulbul. Basically, we do collect from different, like we have a very simple and similar group community, artist community. Like Dagi is one of our friends, Urantu is our friends. So we do talk several times about our works, and when we try to put an open call, we just send them messages and text, do come and join us. So that's how we just collect artists and their artworks and try to share our thoughts. So this is Sanjit's work, and that was Orpita Singha Lopa. Next. Yeah, I really want to mention about this one. Like it was done by Jhoton Sarkar. The building, the palace name is Rose Garden. But the artist put a cement bag at a rose tree in front of that place and named signboard so that people can come and see which one is the rose garden actually. Like now it turns garbage of cement structures like that. Well, this is our next season. I mean, it was done by 2015. The Cartoon Hall, mostly with the students from Dhaka University know that place very well. The Cartoon Hall was a British Raj era building and home of the Faculty of Science at the University of Dhaka. The building was originally intended to be Town Hall and is named after Lord Cartoon, the Viceroy of India, who laid its foundation stone in 1904. upon the establishment of Dhaka University in 1921, it became the base of the university science faculty. On that season, like 18 individual artists joined and did their works. Yeah, that was one of a work from Shubho Shaha. Yeah, Fazlur Abbi did this work, like he was planning to redesign a tree, organic form, with something like that, like cubic shape. A performance from Sanjeev Mahmood Bulbul. Well, this one is our different project, like we call it Native Needs. It's basically site-specific projects and kind of artist residence program for 7 days. Native Meet, the title of a public art project, is an experimental initiative on Bangladeshi local mythology. Like, we do have a lot of mythological stories in our country. I don't know, somehow Bangladesh is a land of river, and we do have a lot of...
First day, the group of people go there and they try to dig something and try to hang out, like hanging around. And some of them started this work, where is the myth? And they did this land art. These are some of the work, some of the outcomes from that project. Like Jotun did a work with some kind of found objects, green grasses, phytoplankton, and the stuffs. And he tried to make a shrimp, a drawing of shrimp. And the second upper one, Chobi was there. She is one of the members. She went to the villages and asked people to write some stories about ghosts. And really, like childs and other people, they're interested and they try to write down something, some story. And they really hear from their parents or their grandpa, grandmom. And like she brought those stories and hanging top of the palm tree. Well, in this season, like Native Myth, what we just try to communicate with the local people, local students and kids. We went to the local schools and try to do some kind of workshops or conversation with the school kids. And we went there and asked them to draw something mythical or something about ghosts, what they feel, how they can draw, what is a fairy, or what is a ghost, or what is a saint. So they try to draw something like that. Well, this one is the next one, like Native Myth second season. There are many stories about the huge Dighi Jhalmulia in Hurka village. Actually, we were inspired by Hilal Bhai. A few minutes ago, he was there. Like, okay. So he had a film, like he made a film on that village, Hurka, like the Dighi called Jhalmulia. And it's huge. The Dighi is a Bengali word, which means a stable water land, almost 10 times bigger than a regular pond. Jhalmulia Dighi is the only source of fresh drinking water of the village Hurka. People cannot drink from other water sources because of saltiness. Due to an unknown reason, most of the water sources are salty, except Jhalmulia Dighi. Therefore, people of 4 and 5 villages around the Dighi are completely dependent on this water. Many people earn from transporting this water place to place. This area is nearby the Sundarban forest and Bay of Bengal. Maybe this can be the convincing reason of saltiness. Jhalmulia Dighi is the place where people meet each other, and it can be said that the Dighi is the heart of this area. There are many traditional beliefs on this Dighi. The Dighi is losing its depth. Nobody dared to do anything to this Dighi.
change.
It's commonly said that the people who take initiative to dig the dighi for depth, they usually die. This one was like helped, a government organization. They helped us and they supported us for doing a workshop over there so that the people of this area, they can know how to collect water from nature, from rain. And so we did one workshop and three science workshop over there, one art projects also. Oh, these are the school kids. Yeah, there are some of their works. Well, Shonglap. Shonglap is a performance art event based on 21st February and International Mother Language Day. The motto of this project is to create an open platform and exploring the possibilities of live art activity. In 1952, it was a social movement built on the spirit to defend the rights to write in one's mother language. Somehow, February 21st is the 52nd day of the Gregorian calendar. International Mother Language Day has been being observed since 2000 to promote peace and multilingualism. The date corresponds to the day in 1952 when students from the University of Dhaka, Jagannath University and Dhaka Medical College demonstrating for the recognition of Bengali as one of the two national languages of East Pakistan. They were brutally shot dead by police then under Pakistan government near the Dhaka High Court in the capital of present-day Bangladesh. We had two seasons. You can see some of activities from the first season in front of University of Dhaka, Charukala. This is the second season. We did this one at TSC. We just tried to collaborate with 10 artists on that time. Before that, I just want to introduce some of our practices, like Bangladeshi practices about performativity, like performance art. Live art or performance art, what we want to say actually, as an art form is only about 30 years old in the announced art movement of Bangladesh. In this period, like in 1980s, the performance art has been introduced as a medium of art to the Bangladeshi art audience, impacting the varied relationship between artists and audiences. Over the last 5 years, it has become very popular as a dialogic medium in Bangladesh. Many events and workshops of performance art has been organized in recent years, which allowed artists to present themselves through a framework, taking the idea of the body and its place in the world. Since each performer uses the body of each surrounding as living art materials, the communicative element is always re-emphasized, making performance art one of the most popular forms of practice. Our culture and lifestyle is more way performative, as we believe that people of this arena are more related to performance and its essences. I strongly would like to mention Kobigan, Palagan, Lathi Khela, Puthipat, religious rituals like Sakrain, Shankrantis, Ashura, Charak Puja as a performative form. Bagicha has initiated and organized a performance-based international live art Biennale named Dhaka Live Art Biennale for the first time in Bangladesh. In the event, Bagicha has invited national and international practicing performance artists. This year, the theme of this Biennale was cast around the concept of how the body traces languages and culture, profiles of performativity. About 43 artists from 16 countries had participated in this Biennale. We hope this first live art Biennale in Bangladesh would be a big step for the Bangladeshi contemporary art movement towards a future where art would be in proximity with the people as well as the global trends. It was an open call process. There is some of outcome. Syed Mohammed Jakir is in the action. There was a whole team. Well, our upcoming projects, like Native Myth third season is, and Urban Hour third season is on in this year. Like, we are going to do it by August and December. And we are hoping for doing our Dhaka Live Art Biennale next season, because it's a biennale. We are going to do it again in 2019, in February maybe. Thank you. Is there any question that I would like to answer?
About you, both you and Aronto use the term episode to describe your, or sorry, season to describe each edition. And that's interesting, because season is usually something you hear in music or in dance performance.
Or maybe in drama also. Like,
yeah, drama. Yeah. So was that a conscious choice when you picked that term?
No, I just found that season is somehow it's different and sound.
I'd like to know about the open calls you guys publish.
Yeah.
I didn't get to know about the open calls usually. Usually what I found on the Facebook is like the announcement, like this is going to take place with those artists. So tell us about the detail, where to find out the open calls and how to be in the activities you do or in the seasons.
Okay, do you want to know about the open call process?
Yeah, where do you put the open call and what do you include? And okay. I mean, usually when it is out, if you have a certain...
We do have a website, backart.org, and we do own two Facebook pages. One of them only for Dhaka Live Art Biennale, and another one is for backart, the whole backart. So usually we put open calls on the Facebook pages, and recently we just started to put open calls on our website too. So that's how.
I just saw the D-Lab open call that was on, but
you saw that.
Yeah, that was
okay,
on.
Right.
That was D-Lab. Okay, mm-hmm. I was informed. We checked it on the Facebook, but other open calls. What do you include in them? I mean, what is the theme, or is there a theme? Or particular participants, what kind of participants you're looking for? I mean, what do you include in the open calls?
We do have a big, like PDF files. When just we want to announce our programs, we prepare project details and what we are looking for actually, and then we just publish it. So we are waiting, we just for good, perfect responses. And about the projects, like how people want to involve with us. They might be from the art background or not. We just don't bother about it. And then, like, we do have limitations, so we cannot receive all of them.
Do you have your own
basis?
Okay. So
yeah,
not
that's,
constant
that's the
participants?
No, maybe not. It depends, actually. It depends on each of other projects. Like. If you are like, for an example, if you are good at promoting something, so we just want to work with you on that ground, like on promotion.
Uh-huh.
Or if anyone is good at photographing, so we just ask him or her if he or she is interested, then he or she can come and join with us. Like, if I just want to mention about Dhaka Live Art Biennale, it was such a big project, so like we do. We are only six or seven people in our group. We cannot make the whole things. That was not actually possible without some people, like some. I really would like to thank Prachonat. They were there, DUPS, and some of our friends, and you can call like Mohsin Kobir Himalay, who was really, really active on that time. So yeah, that's how we try to.
Yeah, I get the idea about the what was the selection.
Oh, that was not actually like okay. We put when we put open calls, and personally we just told our friends that we are having something, so you can come and join us. Let's work together. So some
was
of them
responded. Oral open call.
Yeah, that was there was open call also, and besides that we just started to tell everyone. If you wanted to work with us, just come and join. Some of them respond and some of them ignore, like, you are a young kid, what are you doing? Yeah, that's very true. We get that kind of inspiration too, like, I would like to say. Sorry, how many?
Women.
Women in our initiatives?
Yep.
Three.
So three out of the seven. Like you said, you mentioned that there are about six or seven of you.
Seven.
Seven. So nearly half are women in your core group.
Yep.